vain. Oh, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you're blessed because of God. Amen. You're living because of God. You're walking the job that you got, the car that you drive, the house that you live in. Don't think that you're so special and you are perfect. It is God that keeps the city. Does anybody know just what I'm talking about? I don't have enough education or enough wisdom to obtain the things that I have, but it's something about favor that it ain't fair. Tell your neighbor, said, I got the favor of God on me. And that favor of God is on your life, it's on your family, and you ain't gonna die. Amen. Stop worrying about God got this. Amen. Don't keep it to yourself. You got to go and tell somebody that Jesus lives. Amen. And Satan is defeated. Tell your neighbor, say, I'm bad. I was bad when I was in the world, and I'm super bad now. And the devil knows I'm bad, and that's why, amen, he's trying to throw everything at me. He's trying to get me off course. Amen. But tell your neighbor, say, hey, Brother Darren, you can't make me doubt him. Why? Because I know too much about him, Elder Shelter. Oh, I've been around long enough. Oh, I got knocked down, but I got back up. And every time he knocked me down, I just keep coming back. Why? Because God is so good. Does anybody know what I'm talking about, Brother Eddie? I'm too close to get my miracle. I'm too close to get my breakthrough. And that's why the devil is fighting you. That's why you got so much trouble. That's why you got so much hell going on in your life. That's why you got so many haters. Why? Because, hey, man, you're on the verge of getting your breakthrough. And the closer you get to your breakthrough, the more the warfare is. The more the devil messes up. The more things go wrong. Why? Because you're on the verge. Oh, tell your neighbor, say, neighbor. Don't tell it. Tell it. Everywhere you go, tell it. Tell them that God lives. If they ask you what's the matter with me, tell them I'm saved and I'm crazy. And I'm sanctified. I'm set apart, Holy Ghost filled. And I don't care who don't like it. And go tell the devil that. Yeah. Oh, we counted you out, but tell your neighbor, say, I'm already in. Oh, who said you would never be? But look at me now. Tell your neighbor, say, you don't look like what you've been through. Oh, it's God's laboratory. Oh, he'll take your black soul and dip it in red blood, and you will come out as white as snow. How can a cow eat green grass and produce white milk? Only God can do that. And we wouldn't serve a God like that. How can a God, amen, heal you of cancer when the doctor said you were going to die, Brother Isaac? And now your cats are free. That's why you serve God. Because God has done something for him. God is a healer if you want to be healed. God is a keeper if you want to be kept. God is a way maker if you want your way to be made. God is a bridge over your trouble. Oh, he's water when you're thirsty. He's bread when you're hungry. And there's still more healing to go around. And sooner or later, it's going to be your time to be healed. The devil meant it for pain, but God said, if you believe me, I'll make you out of a miracle. Is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? Oh yeah, the devil's after you. If you ain't doing nothing, the devil ain't after you. But when you are a threat, that's why you got trouble. That's why your kids acting crazy. That's why your wife don't know what you're talking about. Because when you are anointed by God, some of the closest people to you can't recognize your anointing. But tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I am anointed.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
I'm anointed.
Hallelujah. Glory to
Jesus. And I know that I'm anointed.
Yes.
And the devil don't want us to get out. That's why he sends division among the believers. Because he knows that with this little group, if we ever get it together, and if we ever get it right, we are a force to reckon with. If we ever get it right, the building is ours, the money is ours, the city is ours. Because why? The world needs what we got. They need deliverance. The school system don't know what to do with their kids. The programs don't know what to do with their kids. But God got the answer. Is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? We can turn your situation around in a minute.
Yes, God. Yes,
Jesus.
Tell your neighbor's name, I'm anointed.
I'm anointed.
Yes. I'm anointed. I'm anointed and appointed for such a time as this. Tell your neighbor, say, if there ever was a time, it's your time. Who's ever taking him and say, it's your time? Oh, it's your time to be blessed. It's your time, son. You will be blessed. You will live out your destiny. You will make it, son. You will have everything God said over your life. Amen. It's going to come to pass.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Glory. Hey, they say, it's my time.
It's my time. Thank you.
And King of devil in hell, stop him when it's my time. My God, I'm a force to reckon with. Hey, I got so much momentum. Hey, amen. I'm fooling myself. I'm getting ready to walk in my season. I'm coming out of my broke season. I'm getting ready to walk in my overflow. Hey, amen. Look, the neighbor says, get ready to happen. And not only for me, but it's going to happen for everything that's connected to this ministry. We're getting ready to have a supernatural wealth shift. Hey, amen. We're getting ready to take back everything that the devil stole from you and the stuff that you gave away. God said, you get ready to get it back in the next 6 months.
Jesus, Jesus.
God told me to tell you the next 6 months of your life is going to be the best 6 months, amen, that you've ever experienced. And that's what you got to tell the devil. Yet, don't you slay me. Yet, will I trust you? I'm in a season, and the devil knows it. I'm getting ready to get myself back. I'm getting ready to get my children back. I'm getting ready to get my money back. I'm getting ready to get my raise. Everything they held up, I'm going to get it back. Don't worry about no money, son. If you honor God and you walk out right before God and you live right before God, God will take you through a season that you got to learn how to live on less. So when more come, you're going to be ready for it. Sometimes you got to learn how to live on less. Amen. And then you will get more. One of the things I know about God is that if the Bible said he never forsake me, then he'll never forsake you. Now, whose words are you going to believe? And the Bible said that the righteous, amen, will prosper, then the righteous will prosper. All you got to do is get right. And when you get right, you're going to prosper. The enemy can't hold nothing back from you. Because the devil don't have no authority. He's illegitimate. He don't have no power. He looks like he got power, but he really doesn't have any power or any authority. Look at your neighbors and neighbor. Everything that's connected to me, getting ready to get blessed.
Woo, Jesus.
Well, you better start hanging around blessed people. You better get next to somebody that's getting blessed. If you see somebody getting blessed and they got some stuff you want, don't hate on them. Don't celebrate with them. Because when God bless your neighbor, that means God's in the neighborhood. No one ain't going to talk to the neighborhood. I just want you to know that God is in your neighborhood. And if he bless my neighbor, that means he's in the neighborhood. And sooner or later, he got to come by my house to get out of the neighborhood. So when he start blessing your neighbor, that means if you're in the neighborhood, that means you ready to get blessed too. Say, never say, I'm blessed.
Thank you, Jesus.
So get ready to get jobs in here.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
The job you had, it wasn't for you. They're underpaying you. Because sometimes God don't want you to settle for less. God wants you to learn how to wait on him. Because he got something bigger. He got something better. He got something greater for you.
Ooh, Jesus. Yes, sir. Thank you.
Because you are a child of God.
Glory, Jesus.
My God, am I helping anybody in here? My God, hear the story. The Bible declared that Jesus comes into the coast of Caesarea Philippi. And he began to ask the disciples a question. He said, whom do men say that I am the Son of Man? He said, my thing is that I wasn't really concerned about what everybody else was saying. God want to know, do you know him for yourself? See, the disciples represented the 21st century church. And if you notice, when Jesus began to ask him the question, that many folk didn't even know who he was. You don't know them because, baby girl, you sing in a choir, or you're a praise dancer, or you show up. You don't know them because of that. Those all the acts that we do in this thing that we call church. Amen. But you know him, Brother Bullock, when you got a personal relationship, when you're challenged all by yourself. Amen. When you're all alone, when you got to make a decision whether to do right or do wrong, and you choose to do right, that means that you know him. And that you made the choice to make Jesus your Lord. Come on, say amen in here. And so the Bible declares, amen, that the 11 said, and the 12 said he was John the Baptist. And you know that John was the forerunner to pave the way for the coming of the Messiah, but he was not the Messiah. Somebody said, well, Brother Pastor, you are Elijah, one of the prophets. Because Elijah, amen, was a prophet unto God. And he did great miracles in his time. Well, somebody else said, well, brother, you are Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. In other words, Jeremiah was a weeping prophet. He weeped for the daughters of Israel. He said to them that they did not know their God. In other words, Jeremiah was a prophet that preached the truth. And we got so many prophets out here today that's afraid to tell the truth. I don't know about you, but even if I'm not ready to live right now, baby, just tell me the truth. If you don't like me, tell me the truth. Ain't no use just smiling up my face. And all the time you're trying to what, take my place. That was a song say, you ain't nothing but a backstabber. And the devil knows your tricks. And anytime you play those tricks, amen, in the house of God, you will never prosper. The Bible said, but Peter, he said, then he turned over to them. He said, I heard what others are saying, and you have been walking with me for a long time, but who do you say that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus turned around and said to him, that upon this rock I will build my church. He said, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Why don't you hop out your neighbor and say, neighbor, everything the devil tried against you, I came to serve notice on you, but it ain't gonna work. He tried to take you out, but that didn't work. He tried to afflict your body, but that didn't work. He locked up your kids in jail, but that didn't work. He messed up your credit, but that didn't work. But you still made your mind up that you're gonna serve God. Because you know that if you stay on the right road, that God will bring you out. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? He said, go tell hell that it won't work. Jesus said, I will build my church. And he told Peter, I will give you the keys. He said, Peter, and whatsoever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven. And whatsoever you loose on earth shall be loose in heaven. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, the keys to my future. It's in my hand. Is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? And the keys represent authority. I want you to know that you got a key that's getting ready to unlock your future. Is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? Why don't you tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, I got the keys in my hand, and I'm getting ready to open up a door called faith. I'm getting ready to open up a door called hope. I'm getting ready to open up a door called abundance. Why? Because abundance shall be in my house. I find your neighbor, and whatever door you want open, just get your keys out and go to shaking them, because our God is an awesome God. Tell your neighbor, say, neighbor, God will bring you out. And Peter said, oh, you are the Christ. You are the anointed one. You are the one that David talked about. You are the wind that's in the middle of the wheel. You are the wind that was in the valley of dry.